How often have you calculated a GPA to know the effects of the pieces? It's just a matter of giving you that little nudge.
Give that little nudge.
All right.
Wait, one more question.
Oh, please!
So that's why you didn't write Mo, that's why you wrote that Sunday.
Right, I didn't write Mo because I wanted to see what you guys thought the graph would have looked like based on those two things. I gave you two of the three measures of center, average, median. I didn't give you the mode, because if I told you the modes were 50 to 60 and 80 to 90, you would have drawn something like this. I wanted you to be surprised by what happened. Does that make sense, Trinity? Yes, this is what's called the population average. X bar was the sample average. Now, why am I calling this a population again? Linda, it's every student I had in Math 95 that term. Every student I had in Math 95 that term. I can call it my population because it was all I was interested in. Fair? Trinity, great question. Thank you. Cool. One last question. How about qualitative data? So suppose, one could argue this is technically qualitative data, but we won't. Suppose I was drawing a graph like the broccoli carrot graph from day two. Oh, exactly a week ago. Seems like longer, doesn't it? A week ago, we did the broccoli carrot graph.
My God, it's only been a week.
Think about this. When this class is over, you're 20% done with 243. Wrap your head around that. That's hard for me. That's hard for me to process. 20th percentile. The graph with the broccoli and the carrots and the potato and whatever, cucumber and the squash.
Yeah.
It was qualitative data, right? If I wanted to ask which average should we use to talk about that graph, what do I have to use? I don't have a choice. What do I have to use? If I were to talk about the typical vegetable that one of you said, or the average vegetable that one of you said, or the normal, predictable, probable, you have to, don't you? Who said that? The mode. Don't you have to use the mode, Michelle? Why can't you do an average?
Qualitative.
Average implies that there's a number attached to the vegetable that you can put on a number line, like this. Remember what we did? We put broccoli, it was carrot. We put carrot here, broccoli here, and then we did like squash, potato, blah, blah, blah. Why did we do that? Because I wanted to make the skew apparent. Could I have put the carrot here and the broccoli here? It wouldn't be a Pareto diagram, but I could easily graph it that way, right? But if I take the 50 and 60 and put it where 70 and 80 is, I break the number line, right? So for qualitative data, you can break the number line because there's no number line. It's a verbal axis. So you can't talk about averages because averages are numerical. They're out. Can't talk about medians because the medians are numerical by position. The only thing you can talk about is mode. That's it. This is my biggest gripe with student evaluations at any academic institution. You guys do them, right? I'm going to ask you to do them for me too at the end of the term. Strongly disagree, strongly agree, neutral, blah, 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 blah. You should be looking at the modes, but when I get the results back, it's always an average because they've changed the words to numbers. Doesn't make any sense.
Dude, you average 4.6.
That's great. What does that mean? 0.6 agree? It doesn't make any sense. It's got to be mode. Yeah? So when you have qualitative, that's it. You got to have mode. Good so far?
Yeah.
Good. You guys are doing great. All right. I'm going to shut this down for a second.